Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum, dear students. How are you? Students, we have completed the reading and explanation part of this chapter, The Ransom of the Red Chief. And now it's time to move towards the exercise and do question and answers related to this story. Open up page number 20 of your textbook. There they have given us a few questions and we have to answer them properly. In order to answer them properly, we need to understand their language very carefully. Number A, which part of the United States of America is this story set in? Which part of the United States of America? So they are asking about the specific part of the United States of America. The answer is in the very first line on page number 15 of the story. We were down south in Alabama, Bill Driscoll and myself, when this kidnapping idea struck us. So this story is set in the state of Alabama. The answer to part A is the story is set in the state of Alabama in the south of the United States of America. Okay. Part B. Why did the two men decide to kidnap someone? Why? We have to give reason. Why did they decide to kidnap somebody? The answer to this question is in paragraph number 2. Bill and me had about $600 and we needed just $2,000 more to buy some land in Western Illinois. So we decided to do our kidnapping in Summit, a small town. So they decided. Why they decided? Because they needed some money to buy some land in Western Illinois. So you'll write your answer as the two men decided to kidnap someone because they wanted $2,000 to buy some land. Okay? They needed it. Part C. What is the first sign we have in the story that the kidnappers have picked a difficult victim? What is the first sign? We have to find out the first sign of Johnny Dossett or Johnny Abyssinia, that he was a difficult victim. What was the first sign? If you read on page number 15, one evening we drove in a buggy past old Dorset's house. The kid was in the street throwing rocks at a kitten on the opposite fence. "Hey," says Bill, "would you like some candy?" The boy threw a piece of brick at Bill's head. So how did he answer to Bill? He threw a piece of brick at Bill's head. This was the sign. This was the very first sign that the kidnappers have picked a difficult victim. Okay? The answer to part C, the first sign that the kidnappers have picked a difficult victim, is that he throws a rock at Bill's head. Part D. What do we learn about Abyssinia Dorset? Who was he? We have to answer about Abyssinia Dorset, father of Johnny Dorset, the boy who was kidnapped. Just read out paragraph number 3 on page number 15. You'll find the answer to part D. We selected for our victim the only child of a prominent citizen named Abyssinia Dorset. So Abyssinia Dorset was a prominent citizen. He was known for his wealth, which he made from lending mortgages and making foreclosures. Right? So this is that we know about Abyssinia Dorset. We learned that Abyssinia Dorset is a prominent citizen. Why are we using is? Because the question was asked in present tense. Therefore, we are using is in the answer. Otherwise, we would be using was. Okay. Known for his wealth, which he made from lending mortgages and making foreclosures. Part E. What other crimes have Sam and Bill committed? This word, other crimes. This phrase is telling us that they are asking us about some other crime other than kidnapping the boy. Okay? We do not have to mention kidnapping of Johnny Dorset, but we have to find out some other crimes of Sam and Bill that they would have committed. We have to find out some other crimes of Bill and Sam. So students, if you read out the chapter very carefully from top to bottom, from the beginning to the end, you'll find out that Sam and Bill have not committed any other crime. At least author has not mentioned any of their other crimes in the story. Okay, so we can write the answer by our own opinion. Okay, we have to give our own opinion in this answer. We can write the answer as, in the given story, the author has not mentioned any other crimes of Sam and Bill. Sorry, any other crimes Sam and Bill have committed apart from kidnapping Johnny Dorset. However, it seems they were not professional criminals as they surrendered quite earlier than expected. So this is my opinion. You can write the answer of your opinion. You can give any of your opinion. You can write in your own words. You can write anything you perceive, right? I thought that this would be the appropriate answer, so I have written this, that they were not the professional criminals as it was seemed from the story, that the boy really gave them a hard time and they were very upset about how to deal with the boy, and they surrendered very early. Part F. What do we learn about Johnny Dorset? First, they asked us about the father, Ebenezer Dorset, and now they are asking about the boy, Johnny Dorset, that what do we know about him? So we have to find out about this boy from all over the story, because the author has told us some things about the boy in different parts of the story. If you just look at paragraph number 3 on page number 15, the kid was a boy of 10, that is, he was 10 years old with freckles and bright red hair. Bill and me figured that Ebenezer would agree to pay a ransom. So this was about his physical appearance, that he was a boy of 10 and he had bright red hair. Then we come to know that the boy was a naughty one because he threw a piece of brick at Bill's head. Then come to page number 16. There you'll find that he was a super active boy. He was playing with Bill and Sam and he made him captive. So he was a very super active one. He liked camping. You see, I never camped out before, but it's fun. He was a talkative boy. He talked too much. So these are some things that we came to know about Johnny Dorset. So we'll write the answer as, we learned about Johnny Dorset that he was a naughty boy, he was super active, he liked camping, he talked too much, he was 10 years old, he has red hair. You can add anything in it of your choice. If you find anything interesting from this story, you can add up over here. Okay, students, it's on your discretion. Part G. What games did Johnny play? What games he was playing with Bill? Students, you'll find the answer to this question on page number 16. How cursed preface, pale face, do you dare to? How dare do you dare to enter Red Chief's camp? He's all right now, says Bill. We are playing Red Indian. I'm old Hank, Red Chief's captive, and I'm to be scalped at daybreak. Ouch! That kid can kick hard. So they were playing Red Indian. The name of the game was Red Indian. So the answer to this question would be, he played a game in which he imagined he was a Red Indian. He supposed himself to be a Red Indian. Part H. Why did Bill try to release Johnny before they had the ransom? Why? We have to give reason that why Bill tried to release him. On page number 18, you'll have the answer, but you have to write it in your own words because they have not given you in the exact words. So just read from here. Sam says, Bill, I'm sorry, but the boy is gone. I have sent him home. I have been subjugated such awful tortures. I reached my limit. So this was the reason why he released Johnny before they had the ransom. Okay. And here he is also saying, I'm sorry we lose the ransom, but it was either that or me to the madhouse. So this is telling us that the boy was driving him crazy, was making him mad by his awful actions. Okay, students? So we can write the answer as Bill tried to release Johnny before they had the ransom because the boy driven him crazy. वो उसने पागल कर दिया था बिल को. Part I. How did Sam and Bill get Johnny to go home? How did they make him to go home? The answer to this question is on page number 19. That night we got him to go. Where? To his home by saying that his father had bought a new toy for him and we were going to play with the new toys the next day. So this was the words of Bill and Sam that made the boy go back home. So we'll write the answer as Sam and Bill got Johnny to go home by telling him that they were going to play with the new toy his father had bought him. Okay, students? Part J of the easy questions, where did Bill say that he would get to in 10 minutes? Part 1. Part 2, is that possible? Part 3, what does he mean? So we have to give the answer in parts. Where did Bill say that he would get to in 10 minutes? We need to find out the place. Where was he claiming that he would get to in 10 minutes? The answer to this question is on page number 19. That in 10 minutes, I shall cross the country and be over the Canadian border. So this was the place he would be there over in 10 minutes. So is this possible? Is that possible? No, that is not possible. So what does it mean? He meant to say that he would be going as far as away as possible to get away from Johnny. So students, you'll write the answer. Bill said that he would be over the Canadian border in 10 minutes. That is not possible. He meant that he would be going as far away as possible to get away from Johnny. Now students, we have a bit difficult questions. Part K and Part L. What effect did Johnny have on the two men? Now here you have to write your own opinion. That what effect did Johnny have on the two men? How Johnny affected the two men, Bill and Sam? You can write the answer as Johnny put a great effect on the two men by exhausting and frightening them. Unko thaka ke aur unko khaufzada karke unke upar bahut zyada asar dala tha Johnny ne. Kin par? Bill aur Sam ke upar. Then we have part L. Which characters do you feel sympathy for? Why? Students, we have a number of characters in this story. Mr. Dorset and then his boy Johnny, then Bill and Sam. So which of the characters are the ones for whom you feel sympathy? For whom you feel sorry? Kin ke liye aapko jo hai wo dil mein अजीब सा फील होता है और उनके लिए हमदर्दी आपको फील होती है. सो यू हैव टू जस्ट पिक अप अ कैरेक्टर ऑफ योर चॉइस एंड देन यू हैव टू गिव रीजन दैट व्हाई डू यू फील सिंपैथी फॉर दैट कैरेक्टर. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ कम टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 2. रेफरेंस टू कॉन्टेक्स्ट. यू आर गिवन टू पार्ट्स ऑफ डिफरेंट पैसेजेस. यू हैव टू आंसर गिवन 3 the answers of the given questions under them. At last, I fell into a troubled sleep and dreamed that I had been kidnapped and chained to a tree by a ferocious pirate with red hair. Question number 1. Who is this about? Who is this about? This is about Sam. Sam is dreaming about Johnny. Who is dreaming? Sam is dreaming about Johnny. Why is his sleep troubled? He said that at last I fell into a troubled sleep. Why did he call his sleep as troubled? क्यों उसने कहा कि बड़ी एक तकलीफ दे उसकी जो है वो नींद थी. क्यों उसने ये बात कही? Because he has kidnapped Johnny, but it was not going according to the plan. क्यों उसको नींद नहीं आ रही थी? हमें पुरसुकून नींद कब नहीं आती? जब हम बाहर से परेशान होते हैं और यहाँ पर उस वक्त उसकी परेशानी क्या थी सैम की, यही परेशानी थी कि सैम ने किडनैप किया था जॉनी को लेकिन कुछ भी प्लान के मुताबिक नहीं हो रहा था। देन पार्ट थ्री, व्हाई इज दिस अ स्ट्रेंज ड्रीम फॉर दिस कैरेक्टर टू बी हैविंग, तो इसमें अजीब सी बात क्या थी, इस तरह का ख्वाब देखने में अजीब सी बात क्या थी कि सैम ने देखा कि उसको किसी ने किडनैप कर लिया है और बड़े खतरनाक से डाकू ने उसको किडनैप कर लिया जिसके लाल लाल बाल हैं, तो इसमें अजीब सी क्या बात थी। एक्चुअली सैम इज द किडनैपर एंड द बॉय वॉज विक्टिम, असल में तो सैम ने किडनैप किया था और जो बच्चा था उसको किडनैप किया गया था, ठीक है वो विक्टिम था, लेकिन ख्वाब में क्या दिख रहा था, बट इन हिज ड्रीम द रोल्स वर रिवर्स्ड, लेकिन ख्वाब में इसका बिल्कुल उलट दिखाई दे रहा था, सैम को ये लग रहा था कि सैम को खुद किसी ने किडनैप कर लिया है। सो दिस वॉज समथिंग स्ट्रेंज अबाउट द ड्रीम। ओके स्टूडेंट्स, देन वी हैव पार्ट बी, आई थिंक मिस्टर डॉटसन इज जेनरस फॉर मेकिंग अ सच एन ऑफर, दीज आर द वर्ड्स सेड बाय होम, हु इज द स्पीकर एंड टू होम आर द वर्ड्स एड्रेस्ड, दीज आर द वर्ड्स सेड बाय बिल टू सैम, ये आखिर में इनकी कॉन्वर्जेशन हुई थी और ये किसने कहा था, बिल ने कहा था सैम को कि मिस्टर डॉर्सर जो है वो बड़े सखी इंसान है कि वो हमसे इस तरह की ऑफर कर रहे हैं कि इतने पैसे मुझे दे जाओ और मैं बच्चा लेने के लिए वापस तैयार हूं। हु इज मिस्टर डॉर्सेट एंड वॉट इज हिज ऑफर, मिस्टर डॉर्सेट कौन थे, मिस्टर डॉर्सेट वॉज जॉनीज फादर एंड वॉट इज हिज ऑफर, और क्या ऑफर किया था उन्होंने, He offered to take Johnny back only if kidnappers pay him $250. उन्होंने यही ऑफर की थी ना कि $250 मुझे दे दो और मैं बच्चा वापस लेने के लिए तैयार हूं। अपने ही बच्चे के बारे में किडनैपर्स से कह रहे हैं कि मैं अपना बच्चा उस वक्त वापस लूंगा जब तुम मुझे $250 दे दोगे। Why is this offer unusual in this situation? तो ये ऑफर में अजीब सी क्या बात है, इसमें हैरत की क्या बात है। Because the ransom is paid to the kidnappers, not by them. इसमें जो unusual बात है, जो एक usually नहीं होती, आमतौर पे ऐसा नहीं होता, बल्कि आमतौर पे क्या होता है, kidnappers को पैसे दिए जाते हैं, kidnappers खुद किसी को पैसे नहीं देते। So this was something unusual that happened in the story. Here students, exercise A, question number 1 and question number 2 has been completed. I hope you would have understood all the answers very clearly. Still, if you have any sort of questions, you can ask me in the comment section. Please like the video, share it with your friends, subscribe to the channel, press the bell icon. Take care. Allah Hafiz.